Although drug combination analysis has been widely used to study drug-drug interactions and improve efficacy of single agent, it is not without limitation and criticism. To avoid pitfalls in drug combination studies, the following fundamental, scientific concept, and practical issues need to be addressed. The term synergy is used extensively as a gold standard to justify drug combinations when designing clinical studies. However, it has been shown that in most studies, the term synergy is used without appropriate understanding of either the underlying concept or the methods necessary to evaluate it. Experiments are commonly designed in such a way that they could not detect synergy, even if it was present, and results are interpreted as showing synergy when there is no evidence for it. Experiments in which any drug is tested at less than 3 dose levels are therefore not likely to be sufficient to demonstrate synergy. It is also worth mentioning that the positive combination effect of 2 drugs can take other forms than synergy. When only 1 drug is active alone, a greater combination effect is generally referred to as potentiation. When the drugs combined are not active alone, an effective combination is termed colism. A combination can also have an effect on a range of biological systems or anatomical sites that are not completely covered by any drug individually, a situation described as cooperation. The analysis of drug combinations requires a standard reference analysis framework. This framework should ideally provide a clear definition of additivity, synergy, and antagonism, and not rely on knowledge of mechanisms of action that are often unknown or not well understood even for many common drugs, such as aspirin. It should be general enough to cover rare and specific cases, and not result in counterintuitive results. It should also be readily adapted to possible practical and ethical issues to obtain data, and be intuitive and user-friendly to be adopted by most scientists. To date, there is no universal method that fulfills all the aspects of this task. Dose-effect approaches based on low additivity can best survive criticism, but the relatively large amount of data required can make combination experiments prohibitive when data are expensive or difficult to obtain. Effect-based approaches such as highest single agent, response additivity, and bliss independence appear more adapted to practical limitations, as one minimally needs 3 or 4 experimental points for their application. Despite their limitations, they can provide sufficient and convincing evidence of positive combination effect. In this context, we feel that the search for a reference analysis framework will not find its solution in one ideal model, but rather in using a set of appropriate methods adapted to each step of the research and development process, from discovery to translation into clinical use. The discovery step is often dedicated to the in vitro screening of combinations of a set of candidate drugs administered at various doses in order to identify one or several combinations of interest. For each drug, screening experiments should explore drug doses that span the anticipated region of activity upon and below the EC50, depending on the current state of knowledge. The combined application of methods such as the highest single agent, bliss independence, and low additivity may be useful to identify good candidates for further mechanistic or clinical research. Then in vitro and in vivo preclinical studies should determine more precisely the nature and extent of combination effects selected from the discovery step. At this stage, single dose effect curves should be well characterized, and a dose effect approach based on low additivity with combination index and isobologram analysis appears as the more suitable method. In situations where dose effect curves are not available for all the drugs combined, such as potentiation or colism, the highest single agent approach is appropriate. When moving to clinical studies in humans, the analysis of drug combinations has to face strong practical and ethical limitations, and it is generally nearly impossible to obtain sufficient data to clearly and properly support synergy. In this context, recommendations from the US FDA's co-development of 2 or more new investigational drugs for use in combination, the European Medicines Agency guideline on fixed combination medicinal products, and the WHO guidelines for registration of fixed-dose combination medicinal products should be used as a reference. In summary, these agencies agree that there should be compelling basis and rationale to justify the use of a combination therapy supported by the biology of the disease of interest and preclinical studies, preferably in animals, as well as strong reasons to justify that the components cannot be developed as individual agents for the studied disease. The clinical development should provide evidence that the combination has a greater efficacy than any of the active drugs given alone at the same dose, or results in a level of efficacy similar to the one achievable by each active drug at higher doses, with a better safety profile. For each phase, the amount and types of clinical data needed and appropriate study designs vary depending on the nature of the combination being developed, the disease to be treated, and what is known from the previous phases. Often, a large four-arm clinical trial consists of placebo or standard of care. Drug A, drug B, and combination is needed to meet the requirement of the agencies. When the contribution of each drug to the combination is convincingly demonstrated from the previous phases, when it is not ethical to treat patients with a placebo or a suboptimal therapy of doses, or when the recruitment may be difficult or slow, such as in rare indications, the required combination study design may be simplified. The benefit of a combination therapy is not simply due to the property of the drugs, but could also depend on the dose ratio. As the cells do not make the difference between a single drug or a combination, two drugs combined at a given ratio could be considered as a third agent with its own dose-effect relation. Therefore, rather than simply asking whether a particular combination is synergistic, we might do better to consider what dose ratio optimizes the synergy. For this purpose, a multiple-ray design exploring a given set of fixed ratios, where the dose of one drug is escalated while the dose of the second remains constant, should be preferred to the full factorial design considering all the combinations of the selected doses of the individual drugs. From their different dose ratios can be compared by the mean of their respective dose effect curves by applying a curve shift analysis and a 3D response surface analysis. Spanning the explored region of doses can provide a more complete description of the combination effect. Ideally, the dose ratio should be optimized in preclinical studies before proceeding to clinical testing in humans. An additional problem in interpreting drug combination effects is the quality of the measured data. Biological systems invariably carry experimental error, and thus borderline cases are almost impossible to assign. For example, should we report a combination index of 0.97 as a true and convincing combination effect, or as a simple deviation from one due to experimental variability? If the 95% confidence interval is of 0.95 to 0.99, we can conclude that the combination index is different from 1, whereas if it is of 0.85 to 1.05, the drug combination cannot be considered to show any effect deviating from the additivity, statistically speaking. The highest single agent and response additivity approaches come with a natural measure of significance as they are based on the statistical testing of the combination effect against the maximum individual effect. But combination indexes resulting from Bliss independence and low additivity are generally reported without any assessment of the degree of certainty to be made from an experiment. These approaches lack the theoretical framework to allow for a direct statistical inference. Thus, for the visual and symbolic expressions, a semi-quantitative expression has been proposed. Drug combination analysis is often presented on drug pairs in order to ease its understanding and because it covers the most common situation in practice. But combining more than two drugs is not so rare. For example, cancer chemotherapy regimens can easily reach four or five agents. Although most of the methods described here can easily be extended for use with any number of drugs, however, analysis of more than two drugs does not allow investigation of the contribution of each drug to the whole combination effect. A combination of three drugs A, B, and C with a synergistic effect could result from the synergistic effect between drug A and drug B only. A complete understanding of the contribution of each drug to the whole combination effect would require an assessment over all the sub-combinations, which is generally not feasible in practice. When the combination is based on logic, such as the combination of two new investigational drugs A and drug B with a reference treatment C, the analysis should follow the same logic in order to show that A and B are synergistic, and that the combination of A plus B with the reference treatment C is also synergistic. In conclusion, The advantages of combining drugs are well recognized, and activity in the area has increased dramatically thanks to the opportunities provided by the enhanced understanding of systems biology of disease. Methods to generate and analyze data have also evolved substantially over time thanks to substantial improvements in screening technologies and computational capacities. However, identification of combination therapies remains challenging. In vitro methods which screen all possible combinations by experimental trials are time and money consuming, and usually only a small number of synergistic drug combinations can be identified. To bridge the gap between urgent need and low yield, state-of-the-art systems biology approaches coupled with the use of artificial intelligence and machine learning to enable rational identification of combination therapies can enable understanding of drug interactions at the molecular, cellular, physiological, and organismal levels. Such multi-scale understanding can enable precision medicine by promoting the rational development of combination therapy at the level of individual patients for many diseases.